also want to thank my my editor, Kevin Lewis, who the book that we're showing today is something that he worked with me on the artwork on, where I wrote and illustrated A Taste of Colored Water.
Dan, and everyone at Simon & Schuster for having me here, for making Amsterdam such a great place to publish books. Doing something wrong already? This sort of messy pile is probably the best representation of that I've made.
If anyone knows my book, where I did a lot of black line work and then the color, because there were no words, the line of the characters and the color were telling the story. So I wanted to do kind of the same thing, because there are very few words in this book to tell the story. And so I chose in this one to use gold instead of black line. We printed all my black line in gold, and then all the characters are in color in the front.
The gist of my book is just, as anybody who does an alphabet book, is that you make a list of words. In my case, I was interested in words, not just things, like for letter M, for example, instead of using monkeys and things like that, I wanted to think about words like monumental and massive and monument. Then here, this is my very early version of a spoon sculpture. So you have, of course, this is slate black coloration. It's slanted, sloped, it's sort of a semi-abstract, right? It's shiny, it's smooth, it's sitting on a sunken sphere. Originally I was going to have shag, but I thought that was a little too much. And then I have a square, and then eventually there's a slit in there. And then when you light it a certain way, it casts this shadow, and then the shadow is the letter S.
I have illustrated many more books than I have written. I also write some of the books that I've illustrated, but it's always so much fun for me to get a manuscript to illustrate, because I never know what I'm going to get. This book was such a puzzle to work out, but Big Bad Bunny, we opened the story with a very scary, menacing creature.
That book is called All God's Critters Got What's All God's Critters, which is taken from a song, campfire song, which was called A Place in the Choir by Bill Staines. And if any of you are familiar with any of my work, most of the work that I've done has been pretty heavy. Biographies on slavery, the Underground Railroad, Abraham Lincoln, the Negro Baseball Leagues, and I really wanted to try something different. So one day I was in the office with Kevin, Lewis, and Paula, and I was telling them that I really wanted to do a book on animals, because I hadn't done anything like that. Kevin had remembered a song from camp that he sang, and he actually sang it for us, which I won't do today. I'm not going to embarrass myself.
I did a discussion group.
In their eyes, this was a book about crafts and the materials that we all use with kids in the making of crafts. From that came, in my mind at least, the idea of dishevelment, because craft projects always start disheveled. Having had children and seen them off to school or my youth, I realized that the state of mind that most of us have when we go off to school is disheveled. So getting oneself together seems to me literally and figuratively to be the problem of getting ready for the day. So suddenly we were thinking, school, day, reason for the day, reason for getting oneself together.
Why are jackets such a problem for me? I really don't know, but it occurs to me that perhaps it has something to do with the fact that I always do them last, that they have to be done last, because only then do I understand what the book was all about, and the jacket is supposed to convey what the book is all about somehow in one strong image. And I don't, like some of the other people that have talked to her today, I don't always know what the book is about until I've done it. So in fact, so in a way, when you go into a store or a library and pick out the jacket, pick up a book, you're seeing the jacket first and then going inside, but I'm working exactly the opposite. I'm working from the inside out. And Dan Potash, my editor, my art director, came up with, I thought, the perfect cover for the book. And my reason for thinking that it was perfect was that I didn't have to do any work. And actually, nobody's ever done that before. Nobody's ever made a jacket from one of my books, from one of the pieces of interior art. But in this case, that painting reflected so much my first idea that I thought it was great. And Dan liked it, and our editor liked it, and the president of the division liked it. And then somebody else came in with a different argument and said, it looks like the book is about a Western. You know, the mountain, the sunset, person on a horse. And after flying into a rage, I had to admit that that was true. And so we started putting the children in the cover, and Dan continued his efforts to do the jacket by taking things from the interior of the book so that David could lie on the floor and take a nap or something. I guess I was really reluctant to do a jacket for this book. We got, you know, there is one version of the 15 or 17 or 20 covers that were made that it isn't here. You know, when I finally decided that I needed to paint something, I did, well, this is sort of representative of it. I mean, look at this. What is this? Why did we reject that? Maybe it's because it says, Psycho Boy looks like a dark figure moving through the snow. I did another one of the children that was standing in a mountain with a cabin in the back that was like, two children isolated and a dark figure in the night. Just wasn't working. And then there was that. Dark figure on a horse with a Raymond Chandler getaway car. What the hell did I do that for? Look at those ugly colors. My God, I thought that was so great when I painted it. This whole afternoon had just been a flurry of insecurities. Me and other people, you see what a really horrifying process. Dark, you know, boiling mess we're all in trying to make these books. I want to say I'm lucky to go last here because I get to compliment each and every one of my fellow artists.
Bravo!
It's a very difficult process. Wonderful creative solutions that you've all come up with. I want everybody to take a look at Matt Faulkner's book on the page where there's this billboard for white bread. It's one of the greatest uses of the gutter that I've seen. He's got this landscape, and the kids are going to town, these white kids are going to town, and then there's this billboard that's all about white bread and Snow White. And then in the gutter, you'll see there are some people off in the field loading some things onto a truck that looks suspiciously like bales of cotton, I'm not sure what they are. And they're in the gutter of the book. And you know, the gutter is this little trench that we all have to deal with when we're making a book. It's absolutely the strangest way I've ever made a work of art is to have to paint around and stay away from this gutter. But in this case, Matt put those people right in the center, right in that gutter. And it's a pun, folks. Most people are in the gutter. What am I talking about?
God, that is.
It's great. But only an illustrator would get the joke. Everybody else is going to see some people stuck in the gutter, trying to reach.